Welcome back to Consider This. Melissa and Sherrod here with you tonight. Now, Malaysians were left reeling after the Ministry of Health confirmed last week that the first case of polio in the country had emerged, and this after being declared polio-free 27 years ago. The news was particularly shocking because vaccinations, thought to eliminate 99% of the risk of contracting polio, is widely available at all Malaysian government hospitals. So what has happened? Now, to discuss this further, we have joining us in the studio Dr. Megat Muhammad Amirul Amza Megat Hashim, Exco of Strategic Planning for a Vaccination Campaign of Medical Mythbusters Malaysia, which is a registered NGO. Welcome, Dr. Amirul, to the show. Now, how have you made sense of what has happened?
Right. First of all, I think it's quite a sad news that we can see that our country has actually gone backwards in terms of the health issues. Because, like you said just now, polio is something that has been eradicated. We are certified a polio-free country since the year 2000. And our last polio case is somewhere in 1992. And for the past 27 years, we have been freed of polio. But recently, we have another polio case in Tuaran, Sabah, which is something that is quite shocking and also saddening.
Okay, so when you looked at the headlines, what were your theories? I mean, do you have a base way of explaining to yourself what could have happened?
Okay, I would put the blame on vaccine hesitancy and vaccine refusal all the way. And I would say that this is all because of the anti-vaxxers. Okay, partly we need to understand that the viruses, particularly polioviruses, does not know of any borders. And similarly to the movement of anti-vaccine, it does not only happen in Malaysia, it also comes from all sorts of other countries as well, as the US, in Philippines as well. So what happened is actually the vaccine refusals has increased, not only in Malaysia, but also in the Philippines. And we also have seen that there are also outbreaks of polio in Philippines since September 2019. Mm. So what we are seeing in our neighbouring country, we have already seen in Malaysia.
Okay, well, we'll come back to the vaccine hesitancy with Dr. Amirul in just a minute. But we have joining us on Skype YB Jennifer Lasimbang, Assistant Minister of Education and Innovation for Sabah. Now, she previously worked with UNICEF and had recently highlighted that Sabah's current polio problem could have been averted if the Federal Health Ministry had heeded UNICEF's warnings 5 years ago. Thank you so much for joining us, YB Jen. Now, you worked with UNICEF between 2014 and 2017. So why don't you tell us the backstory to these polio warnings?
Okay, good evening, everybody. Back in 2014-2017, I was working as a consultant to UNICEF Malaysia. And my main work is looking at issues that children face, in particularly in Sabah and Sarawak. But most of my work actually was in Sabah. And we were actually very, very worried about a particular population, a group of children, i.e. the undocumented children in Sabah. And so knowing that children without documents, the progression is they wouldn't have an identity, they wouldn't have had the access to healthcare and education. And one of them is the situation or the possibility of them being not vaccinated or not immunized.
What was the follow-up then? I mean, if you had issued, UNICEF had issued a warning to the federal ministry, what did you get in response?
What we were trying to do was to work with the Philippines embassy to get the vaccines. We know that the MOH does give vaccination to migrant workers and also undocumented persons with a fee. And knowing that they wouldn't be able to afford that vaccine, UNICEF, I'm speaking as then a consultant, we tried to work with MOH to administer vaccines that would be provided by the Philippines embassy in to assist us in the issue.
Do you think, YB Jen, that it's actually short-sighted for the Malaysian government to rely on other agencies or actors to bear the cost of the immunization when in fact it has a direct bearing on the health of local populations? I mean, why not just take on that, that financial burden for the good of Malaysians?
Well, it happened 5 years ago or more. And because of that warning, we were trying to work out something with the Ministry of Health, particularly with the Department of Health in Sabah. But unfortunately, it didn't happen. So now I know that the Malaysian government is working with UNICEF Malaysia and WHO to remedy this situation at this point.
So, YBGen, you know, there are, according to the Home Ministry statistics, there are some 500,000 undocumented persons in Sabah. 95% of that is children, and they've not been immunized. So the response from the federal government is saying they're now going to immunize all these children. But is that going to be enough? Because polio is perhaps the one that came to the forefront in this time around. What about the other, what is, you know, under the surface? Could polio be the first of many to emerge?
I fear that is the case, because it could have been averted with just a simple immunization practice to immunize all population regardless of their nationality that is staying in Sabah in Malaysia. And I think it's time for us to go and find the solution. We know the situation, and I fear that if we don't do it now, I know that UNICEF, WHO, and MOH is working emergency, in districts that's highly exposed to diseases and under-immunized in certain areas. And we really have to look at this problem. We really look for the solution. We have to do all that we can at this point.
YBGen, thank you so much for joining us this evening. Appreciate your time on this. We come back now to the studio with Dr. Amirul from the Medical Mythbusters Malaysia. What did you make of the comments that YBGen just made?
All right. Okay. I frankly agree with what she has said. It's very important that our Ministry of Health to work with other agencies, including our own other ministries and also the agencies globally, to help us in tackling these issues. What has happened 5 years ago, we must let it go. Okay. We must look what will happen next. Okay. And I believe that the Ministry of Health is doing its best in remedying the issue.
Right, so one of the things that you had mentioned is your sense that anti-vaxxers or decision not to or to refuse vaccination for children is part of the problem. Right. But what about just the technology? Is the technology available for health officials to monitor those borders? Huge borders between Sabah and the Philippines, and Sabah is integral part of the Sulu world. Mm-hmm. On other sides, we have other borders with Thailand and so on and so forth. Do we have the wherewithal? Is there enough money to monitor those borders?
Of course, we are working in a very limited resource, right? And if we were to see the situation, if it's happening in Peninsula Malaysia, it will be totally different. But in Sabah and Sarawak as well, you know, the access towards the place where these people live is even access to them is quite difficult. So just to monitor them, just to make sure all of them are getting vaccinated, and also it's also quite difficult because most of them are not even registered. We don't even have a registry for them. So to ensure that we have covered the immunization for all of them is very, very difficult, actually.
All right, we're going to go to a quick break. But after this, we're going to bust some medical myths and information on social media. We'll be right back with more on Consider This. Stay tuned.